Just want you motherfuckers to know I'm ready.
Come on!
Wow.
Yeah, it also has this mode.
Irritate the neighbor, what is that mode called? I, of course, didn't bring any money.
I didn't either.
I have some in the car, in the Lamborghini.
So obnoxious.
No, it's awful. I left it in my Lamborghini. Perhaps I could, you'd trust me for this.
We're eating in a museum of food. This is really weird.
I've never experienced
this. He's part of the museum. Do you understand how crazy this is?
Yeah, I guess you're right.
We're not in a restaurant. We're in a museum. I'm sure the Chinese have seen the pork, but we're staying with the sticks. How did you learn to do Natalie Portman?
I watched Garden State. She did that thing where she's...
You want to listen to some music? I like music. Everything's so amazing. Wow. I'm things are just so crazy.
There are clubs in England where the comedians are told where the hen night is.
What is hen night?
The bride and... And
oh,
seven.
Oh, like a bridal love.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Where they hire the white limo, and within 3 hours, they're in an alley throwing up their guts and going, don't tell him! Don't tell him! He shouldn't marry me! I'm a disgrace!
You're not a bloody disgrace. You just had too much, babes. Oh, let me hold your hair.
I got vomit on my hair. Yeah. I shouldn't have had that other kebab.
That's a hen night.
She got her hair done for the show.
Really?
Yeah.
What did they do to her? Did they tease it out?
They just wash and fluff, and then they shave the...
So she I don't think I'd want that job.
Yeah. Good girl. Bless you. Bless you. That is the most interesting sneeze I've ever heard. It's tender and full of rage all at the same time.
Worst I ever did ever, I did a jazz club in Queens. Gerald's. I was supposed to get $50, right?
Right.
And there was no dressing room, so I bombed. Then afterwards, I had to go sit in the room with the people you just bombed with. You're sitting there, people are walking by going, oh, shit. And then afterwards, I go up to Gerald. He's a grown man, too. It's really mean to be like this to me. And I went up, I was like, yes, I was supposed to get $50 for the night. And he turned around and said, better get the out of
I love this car.
There it is, Big Lots.
Wow, I knew there's one around here.
I've always wanted to go to a Big Lots. You know what I like about Big Lots?
What?
The exclamation point.
That's what you like about them.
I like the enthusiasm. What's your favorite cereal all time?
I would probably have to say Kellogg's Bran Flakes.
Bran Flakes?
I like.
No wonder you had a depressed childhood.
You start jabbing at somebody with that, you got a weapon, my friend. Yeah, back off, I got a classic cookie collection.
Am I boring you?
Le posso offrire un caffè.
I got inspired in Italy to get my own Vespa. But the guys there, the way they drive and the way they look,
yeah.
I tried to replicate that at home. Doesn't work.
Ah, I know. Jess and I took a trip to Italy. We said, let's have breakfast like this every morning. Prosciutto, cheese, salami, espresso. We tried it twice. It's horrible. Wow, this is fun. Scooters. Now, you've grown this beard.
Oh, you know, I haven't had hair in so long, you know.
You've just turned your head upside down is all you did.
Yeah, really. Everybody has beards now, Jerry. Every man wants to feel like he's doing something that a woman can't do. Women are doing everything that we did. I remember the first time I was in a strip club and a woman walked in the strip club. She's coming to see the women. I felt something's wrong here. This is a man's place. Well, this is the last bastion.
Men are looking to hold on to a piece of their territory.
What can we hold on to?
I see.
The beard.
They feel the advancing army.
It's coming, the femme army.
Oh.
That was beautiful. Now, why not white walls? Get in the car.
All right.
You know, I don't prepare anything for these shows.
No kidding. No. What's the funniest Jewish word?
It might be schnurrer. Do you know what it means?
Nope.
A schnurrer is someone who picks the cashews out of the mixed nuts.
We win the Oscar for Ray. But when I win the Oscar, I don't take the Oscar home. I give it to my manager. You take this. You want it? Nope. I said, because if I take that, I'll buy into the Oscar and I won't be funny anymore. Because when you hold the Oscar, for whatever reason, when I was holding that Oscar, I automatically started to speak in an English accent. There I was in the jungles of Africa, knee-deep in hyena dung, when I was approached by the music of Ray in a spiritual form. And I was, get the f***, I don't want none of this.
Do you have a baby?
I have no children.
No children?
No. Do you have kids?
Three.
Three? Do you regret, like, do you like your kids?
What?
I'm always looking for someone to admit they regret having children.
Oh my God. This is crazy. Does your company make other things other than this show?
Or no.
Do you just do this?
I don't even think my company does this.
You don't even do that?
I don't even know if I have a company. Hey, you want to go to Arby's?
Yeah, let's do it. That was good.
Wow, that was great.